Hi, welcome to Physics Channel. Today let's discuss about the nanoscience. The nanoscience is heard more nowadays because of the development of science and technology to the extent of nanoscale. The central concept of nanotechnology developed over a large period of time. The nanotechnology is not new for us. Nanostructured materials used in the 4th century by Romans to decorate glass and cups. So when we observe these glass cups are decorated by the gold and silver nanoparticles. In 6th century BC, wood steel, high carbon content steel, exported globally by southern India, it was also known as the hukou or envy steel. The idea of building these small things goes to Richard Feynman. He delivered an inspirational talk on "There is plenty of room at the bottom" to American Physical Society on 29th, 1950. In that meeting, he discussed about the controlling and manipulating things at atomic scale. He said, "Atoms can be arranged in the way we want." He mentioned a machine that computes and works by a quantum mechanical laws of physics, that is, a quantum computer. 20 years later, many inventions and discoveries began to appear. The term nanotechnology was first originally introduced by Norino Taniguchi during the scientific conference in 1974. Nanotechnology mainly consists of the processing of separation, consolidation, and deformation of materials by one atom or by one molecule. The invention of scanning tunneling microscope in 1981 and discovery of fullerene in 1985 advances the experiments to the development of nanotechnology. You can see the scanning tunneling microscope schematic view. The fullerene, which was discovered in the 1985 also, you can see, which is the allotrope of carbon. In 1986, Drexler expanded the ideas and definitions of Feynman in his book Engines of Creation, The Coming Age of Nanotechnology. Certainly, they captured the public imagination and propelled the nanotechnology into the popular culture, inspiring the futuristic visions. According to Drexler, nanotechnology is the principle of manipulation atom by atom through control of structure of matter at the molecular level. It entails the ability to build molecular systems with atom by atom precision, yielding a variety of nanomachines. Nanoscience and technology is not new to the nature. There are many objects that function in micro and nanoscale. Abalone, a kind of mollusk, can create shell around its body. The scientists understand that the shell is constructed by a bricks of calcium carbonate with the glue of carbohydrates and proteins. The origin of the term nano comes from the Greek word meaning dwarf. The scientific meaning is 1/1,000,000th of a meter. The particles up to 100 nanometer scale are called nanoparticles. The nanoparticles exist in the natural world and are also created by the human activities. Nanodevices, nanopores, dendrimers, nanotubes, quantum dots, nanoshells. We can see many examples for nanomaterials: gold nanoparticles, nanotubes, nanofibers, silica, large molecules such as the protein and graphene, etc. Thank you for listening to my channel. Please subscribe for further videos.